I'm your host, Brian Makse, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things, and on this channel you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now we're driving the 2021 Volvo S90 Recharge in inscription trim. This is one of the most elegantly designed sedans you can buy today. It is pretty inside and out. And this is a plug-in hybrid, my friends. It's powerful and efficient. Let's go for a drive. If you haven't been paying attention, Volvo is electrifying their lineup and everything is going electric. Of course, there is the Polestar division, which used to be the tuning division, but that's a whole other story for another day. Everything is getting electrified in the Volvo range, and you can buy a fully electric XC40, which we drove not that long ago. But this S90 is only available as a plug-in hybrid in this part of the world. For regular viewers of the show, I have to mention that this is the first episode with the new show format, so please let me know what you think. And while you're at it, if you're not subscribed, make sure you hit the subscribe button and like this, whether you like it or not. No, I'm just kidding. If I'm not doing a good job, don't like it. If I am doing a good job, please like this. For years now, Volvo's been doing gorgeous interiors. This is no exception. It does follow the same design language as all other modern Volvos, but the most important thing is how you're seated, and Volvo does just the most sublime seats. Perfectly supportive, lots of adjustment, very comfortable, and on top of that, they're very safe. They're designed to keep you safe in the event of a crash. In terms of day-to-day driving, these are some of the best seats you can get, period. Given that there's lots of adjustment in the seat and the steering column, you can set yourself up perfectly. I think anyone from maybe 5 feet tall to 7 feet tall can fit here just perfectly. I am very comfortable, have a great relationship to the car, to the steering wheel, love the shape of the steering wheel as well. And it just encourages you to have your hands at 9 and 3. It's worth noting there are no shift paddles on the back of this steering wheel. The controls on the wheel are very simple and straightforward. Just the way I like it. You've got audio controls on the right and adaptive cruise controls on the left. They're so intuitive. It's so simple. That's one of the reasons why I love driving Volvos. It's just so easy to drive these things and live with them on a day-to-day basis. I do have to mention the shifter, this Orifor crystal thing. It's lovely at night. It lights up. It's very elegant, but I do have to mention that to get reverse or to get drive, it's two pulls of the shifter. You get used to it after a while, but the second pull does seem a bit redundant. The rest of the ergonomics are very much Volvo. Very simple, straightforward, easy to understand, not much of a learning curve if you're coming from another brand. One of the things that does require a little bit of a learning curve is this infotainment interface. This screen, for example, has a bunch of different tiles on it. You can change the location of these tiles to change the priority, for example, but otherwise it's a very simple system to use. I think it is Android based and it seems like there's a powerful processor there, so it's very easy to live with. There's no lagging in the system at all, which is great to see. In terms of spaciousness, there are two things I have to mention. Yes, it is spacious. You can see how big it is in this row and the second row. The trunk is modestly sized, not as big as I would have thought, but here's the thing. The battery's not there. What's actually back there is that electric motor. That's part of this very sophisticated drivetrain. But what sits back there is the electric motor for the rear axle. Where the battery resides is here. So there's actually not much storage. Literally, what I have in here right now is my phone cable to charge the phone and connect it to the car, and my keys. That's about all that's gonna fit right here. The other thing I have to mention about this interior is that this seat right now is in its full aft position. It does not go back any further. So I had a tall passenger in here the other day, very tall, unnaturally tall, who knows, a bit of a freak, but nonetheless, this seat needed to go back, and that is as far back as it goes. There's still lots of room back there for the rear seat passenger, but that back seat needs to go back a little bit further. When you've got all the horses and all the torques working together, this thing is very quick. It is exceptionally quick for its size and for its mass, which is just wonderful. I love how quick it is. However, there are a couple of considerations. One, this Polestar engineer drive mode, and hopefully you can see this on the screen. So you've got constant all-wheel drive pure, which is primarily electric. There's hybrid, which does default to electric a lot. And then this Polestar engineered. The Polestar engineered drive mode is basically like a sport mode. So it's a mild sport mode, changes throttle response, changes the transmission shift algorithm. And the other thing it does in this car, because this car has the adaptive dampers, is it changes the damping rate. So that ride does get a little bit firmed up, which is what I prefer. The regular mode for the dampers just doesn't offer enough body and wheel control for my liking, which we'll get into later. So I would like to decouple the dampers from this overall Polestar engineer drive mode, but we can't do that. I'd like to be able to adjust those dampers separately. When you're in the Polestar engineer drive mode, there's no trouble accessing all the horsepower and all the torque, and this is fairly quick. It's got to be an under 6 second car, maybe 5.5 seconds, 0 to 60. However, when you're in that pure drive mode or the hybrid everyday use mode and you want all the horsepower and all the torque, but you've started on just the electric motor, it takes a fraction of a second for that gasoline motor to fire up and then drive power to the ground. Oftentimes, if I want that kind of responsiveness, I'll just switch this over into Polestar engineered mode. But more often than not, I'm driving in town on electric because it's so quiet, it's so pleasant, and I love zipping along silently. And that electric motor only, forget about the combination of the gasoline motor, but that electric motor on its own makes enough torque that this S90 can keep up with traffic without difficulty. Volvo has been doing great advanced driver assist systems for years, works flawlessly here. There's adaptive cruise and there's lane keep assist. It is a little on the conservative side, so expect it to leave a lot of space between you and the car that you're following. Steering is electrically assisted, of course, and it is responsive enough. There is not a lot of feel or feedback that comes through this wheel. That's fine, but as we go through some corners here, it is responsive enough. This car is riding on the larger diameter wheel and tire package, so we get a little sharper turn in response from those tires, but the steering is fine. It is easy to get through a corner, hold a line, no problem, but again, not a lot of feel or feedback that comes through here. Thankfully, it is direct and it is precise, it is consistent. The transmission works fine. It's the same transmission they're clearly using in all the other plug-in hybrid Volvos. Works fine. The only thing I would like in a car like this are those shift paddles so that I don't have to reach down here, shift it over to this B or braking drive mode, and then control the transmission this way. If you're unfamiliar with hybrid systems and how they work, one thing you need to understand is that there is always a regenerative braking function built in, so that when you're cruising, coasting, like down a hill, we're happening to be going up a hill right now, but if you're going down a hill, for example, there's some regenerative braking going on. That means while the car is decelerating or coasting, it's sending some energy back into the battery, and that's very cool. But what that does is it presents a problem for dynamics engineers and how you get good feel out of a brake pedal. There are a lot of hybrid systems that just have a horrible brake pedal, just don't feel great at all, but this one is one of the exceptions. Jump on the brake pedal, great feel, great modulation, nothing funky going on with that brake pedal at all. It does not feel dead, it does not feel lifeless. You've got great feel out of the pedal. This is an executive sedan, not really a sport sedan, so the ride and handling is tuned more for comfort than outright handling, but it still has a decent amount of handling. It's got a decent amount of grip, and this is not something you'll want to throw into corners and play with on its limits. No, this is something that you're going to cruise along very comfortably and quietly, and as I've been doing. Because this S90 has a fairly low center of gravity, there's not that much body roll, certainly not a lot of dive under braking either. Very impressed with the confidence you have when you're throwing this S90 around. Again, it's not something you want to play with at its limits, but in an emergency situation, if you've got to avoid something like I'm doing here, somebody's literally stopped in the middle of the road, nice work. It works wonderfully. So there was not a lot of dive under braking, and there is a bit of body roll, like I mentioned, but otherwise you should expect this S90 to be tuned more for comfort than outright handling. It's very comfortable in here and very quiet in here as well, which I'm impressed with. My verdict, well, straight off the top, this S90 is gorgeous inside and out. It's exceptionally well made. It's just beautiful. It's very different from everything else, and certainly very different in a lot of ways given the nature of this very sophisticated drivetrain. It works very well together, and I just love driving it on electric in the city. Overall, really enjoy driving this car. I think it's fairly well priced against the competition, but I don't know if many people are going to buy this because it is a plug-in hybrid. In terms of fuel consumption, for the most part, I've been getting between 25 and 30 miles per gallon, but regular viewers of the show know that I drive for pleasure, not for fuel consumption, but I have been driving this on electric, as I keep saying, in the city. Love the styling of this. Love how it's finished. This is just a gorgeous place to be inside this S90. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2021 Volvo S90 Inscription Recharge. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because as I understand on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even elegant Volvo sedans.